The next thing we need to check is the view range. You see for instance here we see some of the foundation and we should not. So I'm going to go to view range. I had changed this to unlimited. Now I want to change it back to level 1 and level 1. Apply. Okay, we don't see the foundation anymore. Also a couple of things about the roof plan. So we have already defined the slopes and everything. It's not a bad idea to show that slope is like percentage, and the way to do it in Revit is that we can go to annotate. There is an option for spot slope. I want to use that maybe here. Okay, I can select this one and go to edit type, and I want to make sure that the format is on percentage. It's here under the text part units format. I want to change this to percentage 0. That's good. And unit symbol, yeah, let's do that. Okay, apply. Okay, so as you see it says 1% here, which is correct. We can add more to both the diagonal elements as well as like the horizontal ones in here. So I can go here, spot slope. So I can add one here, add one here, add one in here, one in here, and so on. The good thing about these slope signs is that I can select these ones, all 8 of them, and copy them, check the multiple and constraint, and then I can go to a different span. Next, you can select these ones, again, select all instances visible in view, and you can simply mirror all of them. Okay. The ones that we used a line to pick the slope, it did not exactly work well on those lines. So for those ones, we can use spot slope. We can go one step further and show some of the drains here. It can be either 2D or 3D. If we want to use a 3D item, we can go to component, load family, and if you go to the plumbing folder, architectural, there is one item for drains here, and I can bring that one. Okay, and I can put it here. And all over the drains, which we have 8 of them in here. We can also have a separate sheet for the foundation plan because we have that one here too. Now let's see what schedules make sense to have in this project. So if you go to view, schedules and quantities, if we go to floor, we can have the floor schedule, we can add the area, the level, the count, if there is any mark or type mark we can add it. We can even add the thermal resistance because we already assigned the insulation, is going to show that too. We can add the threshold to see how it works. Okay, how about I have the level at the top, then the area, maybe we don't need count, the threshold, and then thermal resistance. Okay, so this is our wood schedule. We can also go with a total. If you go to sorting and grouping, we can go with total here, and under formatting we can calculate totals for the area. So we have the total floor area. We can also see how maybe some structure elements reflecting the schedule. So we can maybe go with structure column schedule. Okay, as you see, we have assigned an assembly code. In this case we don't have an omniclass number, but if you have one you can add it here. We can go even with the volume, because everything is in wood. We can get the volume of the wood which we need only for the columns. Base level, maybe the count, the structure material. Okay, how about I put the count at the top, and then volume is good. The base level can go second. Assembly code can go down. Okay, so this is all the columns that we have. You see, they're all in different levels, and it shows the volume of the material that we need as well as the structure material. So in this case, we can do something interesting. We can go to edit, we can go to sorting and grouping, go with totals, and this time we can go with the total amount of volume, so we can know what's the amount of the wood that we need for the columns. We can try other schedules too. We can try the structural framing system. How about we add the count, the exact weight. Do we have a volume option? Yeah, we do have a volume option. We also have a weight here. How about type and type mark, if there are any. The length. Okay, so let's see how this one works. Okay, so we have now all the beams in here. I can again go ahead and calculate the total volume of the wood. So if I do that, we see volume. Okay, so you see for the framing system, for the beams, we need about 267 cubic meters. So about the columns, actually when I said 41, it's also considering the concrete columns. Those are the little concrete parts below the wood parts, below the wood columns, which transfer the weight of the columns to the foundation. If we want to get rid of that to see how much wood we have, we actually need to go to Fields, Edit, and we can filter by base level, and whichever starts in foundation will go away, which are the concrete ones. I'm gonna say okay. Oh, actually I should have done it the other way. So filter whichever does not equal foundation. So now the total volume of the wood that we require for the columns is 36 cubic meters, and for the framing we need 270 266. You add up, it's gonna be about 300 cubic meters of wood, and this does not include the floor panels or the wood parts on the exterior walls. If I go back to the floor schedule and I go to edit, I should be able to pull the structural material here as well. Now I can also add the volume in here. I'm not sure if it did add. Okay, so volume, move it to the right side. Okay, now we can see that the wood material that we need for the floors is 2 times 210 for the floors. So if you gather all the volumes, you can get the whole amount of wood that we need in this project.